हेलो ऑल, वी आर गोइंग थ्रू द कोर्स बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग विच इज ऑफर्ड बाई बोथ बीकानेर टेक्निकल यूनिवर्सिटी एंड राजस्थान टेक्निकल यूनिवर्सिटी इन बी टेक फर्स्ट ईयर फॉर ऑल द ब्रांचेज. वी आर फॉलोइंग द यूनिट नंबर वन विच इज डीसी सर्किट्स. वी हैव ऑलरेडी गॉन थ्रू इलेक्ट्रिकल सर्किट एलिमेंट्स, रसिस्टर, इंडक्टर, कैपेसिटर, वोल्टेज एंड करेंट सोर्सेज, KCL एंड KVL, सीरीज सर्किट, एंड इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू कवर parallel circuits, that means resistances which are connected in parallel. Okay, so are in parallel we are going to see. Now consider n resistor R1, R2 up to Rn are connected in parallel. All are connected in parallel. How? Because one end of all the resistance are connected at one node and another ends are connected to another node. Okay, and that's why it is known as parallel connection. We know that in parallel connection voltage across the element will remain same. So whatever voltage I will measure across this Rn resistance, the same voltage will appear across R2 or Rn. Even since this voltage source is also connected in parallel with all these elements, so this voltage V will be equal to E. Now apply KCL at this node to find out equivalent resistance. Okay, so the moment we'll apply KCL, we know that whatever incoming current to this node, we are going to write that as a positive current. So this IT is coming to the node and that's why it is positive current. This I1 is going away from the node, so it will be negative. This I2 is also going away from the node, so it is also negative. Then this IN is also away from the node and so it will be negative. And this is going to be equal to 0 as per the KCL. And so IT is equal to I1 plus I2 plus dot dot up to IN. The same equation is written at this place. Now convert all these currents into the form of voltage and resistances by using Ohm's law. So what we can write, this IT can be written as E upon RT. RT is what? It is the net resistance across this node. Okay, so this IT will be equal to E upon the value of RT, that is the total resistance or equivalent resistance. I1 will be what? The voltage is E across this resistor R1 and resistance value is R1. So I1 will be equal to E upon R1. Similarly, I2 will be E upon R2 and IN will be equal to E upon Rn. So all these E will be cancelled out and will remain with 1 upon RT is going to be equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 up to 1 upon Rn Siemens. Since this is the reciprocal of resistance, and that's why the unit will be Siemens or Mho. Just reverse of Ohm. We know that 1 upon R is conductance. So we can write that GT, the net conductance in case of all parallel connected resistance will be equal to summation of individual conductance like G1 plus G2 up to GN. And unit will be Siemens if you are calculating conductance. So from this equation, we can easily find out the net resistance. So net resistance or equivalent resistance or total resistance RT will be equal to 1 upon 1 upon Rn plus 1 upon R2 up to 1 upon Rn Ohm. This is very important point. In case of पैरेलल कनेक्टेड रेसिस्टेंस से द रिजल्टेंट रेसिस्टेंस विल ऑलवेज बी स्मॉलर देन द स्मॉलेस्ट रेसिस्टर इन द कॉम्बिनेशन. फॉर एग्जांपल इफ दिस रेसिस्टेंस इज हैविंग वैल्यू ऑफ 1 ओम एंड दिस इज हैविंग 2 ओम, दिस आरएन इज हैविंग 5 ओम, दैट मीन्स ऑल रिमेनिंग रेसिस्टेंस अदर देन R1 इज हैविंग वैल्यू ग्रेटर देन 1 ओम, देन द RT विल बी लेस देन 1 ओम. ओके, 1 ओम इज द स्मॉलेस्ट रेसिस्टर कनेक्टेड इन द पैरेलल कॉम्बिनेशन. ओके, देन द इक्विवेलेंट रेसिस्टेंस विल बी स्मॉलर देन द स्मॉलेस्ट रेसिस्टेंस विच इज कनेक्टेड इन द पैरेलल कॉम्बिनेशन. This mathematical formula can be reduced in a simple format if two resistances are connected in parallel manner. So for two resistors, what we can write? RT, the net resistance will be equal to R1 into R2 upon R1 plus R2. But this mathematical formula is only applicable for two resistors. It can't be generalized. Otherwise, generalized format is this one. Now, find out the value of RT in all three cases. So, in this case number one, 3 mega ohm and 1 mega ohm resistances are connected in parallel. Since two resistances are connected in parallel, so RT will be equal to we have a mathematical formula R1 into R2 upon R1 plus R2. So that we are going to apply 3 mega multiplied with 1 mega upon 3 mega plus 1 mega. So finally it is going to be equal to 3 upon 4 mega ohm. Okay, so here it is, 3 upon 4 means 0.75 mega ohm, which mega means what? It is 10 to the power 6. So we can convert that into kilo also. So finally it is going to be 750 kilo ohm. In case number B, this RT will be equal to 36 ohm is the first resistor and 24 ohm is the second resistor. So 36 multiplied with 24 upon 36 plus 24, so 14.4 will be the answer. In case of third, this RT will be equal to parallel combination of 98 kilo ohm and 2 kilo ohm resistor. Okay, so 98k multiplied with 2k upon 98k plus 2k, and which is going to be equal to 1.96. Now see, in these two cases, 1 mega ohm is a smaller resistor now, and equivalent is less than that. In this case, 24 ohm is a smaller resistor, equivalent is less than that. Here 2 kilo ohm is the smaller resistor, and equivalent is less than 2, it is 1.96 kilo ohm, which is less than 2 kilo ohm. Okay, now solve this question. We have to find out RT along with GT. Okay, so firstly, let's calculate the value of GT. So we know that net conductance will be equal to summation of individual conductance. So this will be the formula. And then G1 can be written as 1 upon 18 plus G2 equal to 1 upon 9 plus G3 equal to 1 upon 6. Okay. If you are going to calculate it, the answer will be equal to 0.33 Siemens. Let me delete whatever I have written. Okay, G1, G2, G3. So 1 upon 18, 1 upon 9, 1 upon 6, After solving it, we are going to get 0.333 Siemens, and RT will be equal to 1 upon GT. Okay, RT is equal to reciprocal of conductance, that is 1 upon GT, which is going to be equal to 1 upon 0.333, which is equal to 3 ohm. Okay. So this is the resistance value. Even we can directly calculate the resistance value, and then after taking reciprocal, we can calculate the value of GT. So if we are calculating it directly, so what we are going to write, RT is equal to 1 upon 18 plus 1 upon 9 plus 1 upon 6, and this is going to produce 3 ohm. Okay. And GT will be equal to 1 upon RT, which is the reciprocal of this resistor. So 1 upon 3, that is going to produce 3.333 Siemens. The unit of conductance is Siemens, so that we have to follow. Okay, this is for your help. In calculator, suppose I have to calculate this kind of value. Okay. So you do not have to write bracket that 1 divided upon 18, then plus again start bracket 1 upon 9, then again start bracket 1 upon 6. No. In calculator, we are having facility of x to the power minus 1. Okay. So to calculate it, what we can do, we can type 18 and then after x to the power minus 1. Okay, then a plus 9 x to the power minus 1 plus 6 x to the power minus 1 and equal to, it is going to produce the value. Okay, and if we'll take reciprocal of it, that is whatever be the answer, again we'll press reciprocal of it, then it is going to produce resistance value, that is 3. So do practice of this method in the calculator, because calculator is allowed in the examination also, in the university examination also. The calculator which is having memory, where equations or all other big things can be stored, are not allowed, but normal calculators are allowed, and you can use this method to calculate these kind of equations. So we'll stop over here. In the next lecture, we are going to cover voltage divider rule and current divider rule. Thank you.